Today we are going to discuss regarding cartridge controller. Now this is the basic circuit diagram of cartridge make controller, which is used in handheld strikers or in forklift. Now connections of armature and field of motor and those main contactor connections and other interlock and key switch connections are shown over here. This diagram is just to provide a basic idea regarding connection. This connection may vary from vehicle to vehicle, from configuration to configuration. Now what are the basic connections? The battery 24 volt or 48 volt positive terminal connects to the controller B plus terminal through main contactor, which is also called drive contactor, and a fuse. The battery negative terminal connects to the controller B minus terminal directly. Drive motor field is connected to S1 and S2 terminal of the controller, the motor which is used to drive the vehicle. So the field winding of that is connected to S1 and S2 terminal of the controller. Now the drive motor armature is connected to B plus and M minus terminal of the controller. Controller B plus terminal will get battery positive power only if the main contactor, which is also called drive contactor, is on. It means motor armature will get supply only if the main contactor is on. So this condition is important. When the main contactor gets on, the motor armature will get power from the battery. Field is already getting power from S1 and S2. Now the question is, how this drive contactor or the main contactor gets on? Contactor coil, whether it could be 24 volt or could be 48 volt, gets energized or gets supply at its one side or at its one terminal from the battery positive terminal via control fuse, polarity protection diode and a key switch. Key switch is normally the on-off switch of the vehicle. The other side or the other terminal of the contactor coil gets supply negative from the controller pin number 4. Now when this controller pin number 4 gives supply to the contactor coil, so there are few conditions. The first condition is key switch or the on-off switch must be on. To confirm this, check supply at pin number 16 of the controller. To do this, put your meter in DC voltage mode, connect black probe to negative of the battery, connect red probe to the pin 16, on and off key switch to confirm power at pin 16. If key switch is on, controller pin 16 will read 24 volt DC or 48 volt DC depending upon the battery voltage, right? Second is the interlock switch. So interlock switch must be on. This is the second condition. To confirm this, check supply at pin number 15 of the controller. Again, put your meter in DC voltage mode, connect black probe to the negative of the battery, connect the red probe to the pin number 16, on and off interlock switch to conform power at pin number 15. If interlock switch is on, controller pin 15 will read 24 volt DC or 48 volt DC depending upon battery voltage. Now what is this interlock switch? This could be tiller switch or foot switch or switch or seat switch. If it is a handheld stacker, then this is your tiller switch, right? Now if above two conditions are satisfied, in general if these two conditions are okay, that is if the key switch and the interlock switch supply are present at the controller pins, third important condition is that the drive contactor coil or the main contactor coil must be good, means not faulty. If contactor coil is faulty, controller will not switch on the contactor and it will show fault code 3-4. Three blinks of status LED followed by four blinks on the controller status LED. Now what is this fault code 3-4? Fault code 3-4 means missing contactor, means controller is unable to find out the contactor. What are the other connections on the controller? Now these are few basic connections on the controller. The very important point is these connections may vary from controller to controller, configuration to configuration. This is general idea of connections which may match to most of the controllers. So this is just an idea. Okay, here also the connections are shown. Normally Curtis controller has a 16 pin connector where all the connections are done. Apart from this, there is a 4 pin connector where handheld programmer tool is connected to program the controller as per our requirement. There are other connections used for power connections to the motor. Now fault codes. Very useful to troubleshoot problems by reading fault codes as shown by status LEDs on the controller. In case of any fault, status LEDs will blink to indicate fault codes. Just read LEDs carefully and refer fault code manually. For example, if LED blinks three times first, followed by four blinks after a pause, the fault code is 34. Right? If the LED blinks three times first, followed by two times after a pause, the fault code is 32. Okay? So this is very important to read the fault code correctly and properly, and after that refer the fault code manually. Now this is the fault code manual, where the meaning of status LEDs or the meaning of fault codes has been written. So for example, 3-2 is main contactor welded, or 3-3 is field winding open, or 3-4 is missing contactor, which is a very common fault. Like 4-1 is a low battery voltage, 4-2 is a over voltage fault. So now this is one troubleshooting chart which one could refer to just get an idea of troubleshooting steps. That suppose you have identified the fault, you have read the fault code and you have known that okay, the fault code is 3-4 and it is missing contactor. Now what should be the troubleshooting steps to clear this fault? So here this is one guide. One could refer this troubleshooting chart just to get an idea to eliminate the fault. It depends on your experience of working with the Curtis controller that you will be able to identify or you will be able to troubleshoot a fault properly. This chart is just to give you an idea of possible causes or the possible troubleshooting steps. Now a very important note, that many things are possible to do with this controller only by using the handheld programmer tool, which will connect to 4-pin connector on the controller. Suppose you want to change the motor direction, what to do? Swap wires connected at S1 and S2 terminal of controller. Basically, you are swapping the field winding connections, right? This will change the direction. So thank you very much for watching.